So you're looking for a way to collect data from search engines without setting up a bunch of different tools? Luckily, in this tutorial, I will show you how to use our all-rounded SERP API that will eliminate your worst scraping nightmares. Smartproxy SERP scraping API combines a proxy network, web scraper, and data parser all in one product. But that's not all. Our secret trick is that we filter the best proxies from Smartproxy's over 40 million proxy pool and choose only those that will bring you 100% success rate. This way, we ensure that you don't overspend while scraping, since you only pay for successful requests. Performing a search is as simple as making a post HTTPS request to our SERP API's queries endpoint. First, let's prepare for the scraping. Go to python.org, click the download selection, and download the program. Now we are going to download PyCharm. PyCharm is an integrated development environment that we recommend using for beginners, since it pinpoints mistakes made within the code. But if you prefer, you can skip this step and simply write the code using a word processing program and Python. Okay, let's open PyCharm and create a new project called SERP Scraper. After the environment is ready to go, open the terminal. Type in pip install requests and press enter to install the Python requests library that we will be using. Now let's create a new Python file. Select new and Python file. Name the file SERP Scraper. Now you have completed the first stage and your environment is ready for coding. In the first line, type import requests to import the request library that we installed earlier. In the next line, type import JSON. We didn't install this library earlier since it's in Python by default. In the third line, type this will define the URL in which the SERP API is located. Then in the next line, create a new variable called payload, in which we will define our scraping parameters. There are actually two ways to go around this part of the code. Option 1 is real-time integration. This option enables you to send a parameter set to the API's endpoint and get the requested result. This integration is easier, especially if you are not that tech-savvy, because we will build the URL ourselves and select all the relevant details based on the parameters you have indicated. The second option is proxy-like integration. This is the best and easiest choice if you have used proxies before. Just replace your proxies with our entry node, send your URLs as usual, and we will take care of the rest. If you like, you can send some additional preferences in your request headers too. In today's example, we are going to use real-time integration. So let's specify our relevant scraping parameters. In the first line, type to specify a scraping target. With our API, you can gather data not only from Google, but also from other search engines, such as Bing or Baidu. Then type to specify the keyword that you want to extract within that target. After that, type. You might find that parsing parameter a bit confusing. We type true after parse because we want to retrieve all that precious data in JSON format. If you want to retrieve data in HTML, you would need to type false here. In the next line, specify the Google search page web interface language by typing, then type. The location we are going to choose today is Paris, so type. You can be as specific as you like when selecting the location, since we allow country, state, and city level targeting. Now it's time for a new variable, headers. Here we will further specify our parameters. In the third line, we are going to type followed by a SERP username, a colon, and then your password. Important thing to note here is that in order for the code to work, both your username and password must be encoded in Base64, also called basic authentication. You can do the encoding via sites such as base64encode.org. After your parameters are set, now comes the time to send a request to our SERP API. Type post means that we send a payload to the SERP API. In this case, it's JSON payload together with the headers. In the next line, let's type. This will decode the retrieved data to JSON format. But decoding the data is not enough. We need to make sure that retrieved results are easy to read. Let's encode the data and then decode it to decode the Unicode characters. Type. In the next line, type. This will decode escaped Unicode characters. Then type and remove all leftover escaped characters. And that's it. Now you know how to use our SERP scraping API. All you have left is to click the link in the description and try it yourselves. Till next time.